in the waters, and you can observe the different kind of liquid crystalline phase that you will obtain. So it's a very quick way to study phase behavior. Another way to increase the viscosity is to formulate highly concentrated emulsions. These emulsions are highly viscous, they have a high elastic modulus, they can be turbid to transparent depending the refractive index of your of both your continuous and dispersed phase. And basically, in this kind of emulsion, you separate the 0.74 volume fraction of your dispersed phase. Okay, so if you look it at by optical microscopy, you will observe a morphology similar to forms, with polyhedral droplets very polydispersed. Another way to increase the stability is to decrease the size of the dispersed phase of the droplets as instance. For that, you can use some mechanical methods such as ultradurex or high pressure homogenizers, and you can see that you will decrease the particle size as you with time of use of ultradurex or with the passes inside the high pressure homogenizer. There is kind of emulsions that are very low particle size, such as nano emulsions. Nano emulsions have typical size between 200 nanometers. They are translucent to transparent, and for this size of particles, they will not the gravity will not affect the droplet, so you will not observe creaming or sedimentation. So normally, this kind of emulsion are much more stable than the classical emulsions. Okay. Another kind of dispersion is the microemulsion, that is more kind of solubilization of one phase in the other one, as that you probably know, they are thermodynamically stable. So they will be stable during infinite time at the same condition, at the same temperature. The only problem with microemulsion is that normally you need high surfactant concentrations to form them. In this slide, I show you a stability test performed on some nanoemulsion with different oil to surfactants ratio. And you can observe that the particle size determined by light scattering is very constant over the time in this test during 40 days of experiments. And it remains very constant at 50 nanometers in this example. This example is done with oil, some oils, cremophoriel, and water. Okay, so to obtain this kind of emulsion, such as nanoemulsion, a very good method, you can use high energy methods such as ultradurex, but you are not sure to form this kind of dispersion. Another methods are low energy methods. One of these methods is the PIT, the phase inversion temperature, that is limited to ethoxylated surfactants. And basically, in this method, you will heat or cool the system. You will start with from a coarse emulsions. You will heat the system as instance. Heating the system, you will deshydrate the ethoxylate head of the surfactants, and you will form some this kind of phases, such as microemulsions, that have very low interfacial tension. So decreasing again the temperature, taking advantage of this ultra low interfacial tension, you will form very small droplet size emulsion, so nano emulsion, with low polydispersity. So you will form this kind of emulsion only by heating and cooling the system. Another low energy method that is not constrict to ethoxylated surfactants, but in which you can use also this new kind of surfactant that are more green, let's say, that, such as polyglyceryl or sucrose esters, is the phase inversion composition. In this method, you start from a surfactant with oil mixtures, and you add water to these mixtures. So during the dilution pathway, you will certainly pass by microemulsions too, and you will take advantage of these ultra-low interfacial tensions to form very small droplet-size emulsions such as nanoemulsion. So you can obtain very stable emulsion by this method. Another way to stabilize some actives, for example, some delicate active that can be destabilized easily, is the encapsulation. There is many forms of encapsulation, from the nanodroplets to microdroplets to solid liquid particles, pickering emulsions, liposome. Well, in this slide you have an image of a different kind of encapsulation technology. One of these technology that I will describe you in these two slides is the liposome technology. It consists of a double encapsulation system. In this technology you have some large vesicle, lipidic vesicles, and inside this vesicle you have very small discs that are formed from lipids too. So if you add some actives, the active will absorb on your small disc and will be encapsulated in this large vesicle. Okay. So if you look by T transmission electronic microscopy, you will observe that this kind of vesicle with this smart disc have similar structures compared to the lamellar body that you can find in the skin. Okay. And with this map, with this very small disc that are few nanometers of size, it will allow the actives to penetrate inside the stratum corneum. That is not the case in the typical liposome technology. So in this slide, I show you the example of encapsulation of the beta carotene, for as instance. As you can see, beta carotene is very sensitive in this IR spectra, is very sensitive to light irradiation. So as you can see in this